إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم من همزه ونفخه ونفسه بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون يا ايها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحده وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والارحام ان الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وقال تعالى في كلامه المجيد واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم فأصبحتم بنعمته إخوانا رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي Indeed, all praises for Allah and may peace and blessings be on the last Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. My dear brothers, I want to share with you some things from the Quran and the Sunnah in this khutbah which can be individually and collectively very beneficial for every single one of us. And today, inshallah, in times when we see that there is so much ikhtilaf, there are so many differences going on among Muslims in the Muslim world and everywhere, we are going to see what does the Quran say about unity and how do we go about getting it in our individual lives, inshallah. We will, inshallah, look at 5 points from the Quran and the Sunnah on the importance of unity and how it is beneficial, and we will also see, inshallah, what does Allah teach us about ikhtilaf, because we find popularly many people believe that ikhtilaf is good. There's so many people who say that differences are good. They say these are signs of rahmah from Allah Ta'ala, mercy from Allah Ta'ala, and we find that Allah Rabbul Alameen has not taught us this. My dear brothers, our very important issue which we need to consider is if in our hearts we consider this to be as bad as it really is, we will do something to avoid ikhtilaf. So we find Allah Rabbul Alameen says in the Quran, in Surah Ali Imran, Surah number 3, Ayat number 103, Allah Rabbul Alameen says, وَاتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold on to the rope of Allah strongly and do not be divided. So Allah Ta'ala has told us to hold on to the rope of Allah, bihablillah jami'an wa la tafarraqu. All of us together should hold on to the rope of Allah and should not get divided. And then Allah says, wadhkuru ni'matallahi alaykum, and remember the favor of Allah on you. Remember the favor of Allah on you. Now, which favor is this? Wadhkuru ni'matallahi alaykum. Which ni'mah is this? Which favor of Allah is this? As Allah says in Surah Maidah, Surah 5, verse 3, Al-Yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati. This day I have completed for you your religion and I have completed my ni'mah, my favor on you. So Allah has said, Waskuru ni'matullahi alaykum. Remember the favor of Allah on you. Now that favor is Islam. Remember the favor of Allah on you. Idh kuntum adan, that you were enemies. That you were enemies. Fasbahtum bi ni'matihi ikhwana. And by the grace of Allah, by the favor of Allah, you became brothers. What is the opposite of enemies? Friends. But Allah did not say that you were enemies, became friends. Allah Rabbul Alameen has said that you were enemies and then you became ikhwana, brothers you became. And then Allah says, وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَىٰ هُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ. You were on the border of the fire of hell. You had reached the border, the boundary of the fire of hell. And Allah Ta'ala فَانْقَذَكُمْ مِنْهَا. Allah saved you from there. So Allah Rabbul Alameen saved us. And my dear brothers and sisters, we find that whenever any formula is presented before the world, if someone says, I have a formula for this, So the first question is, has it been applied? Has it been applied anywhere? Has it been tested and applied? And what were the results? Was the formula applied anywhere? This is the normal question. We are going to see today, inshallah, the formula, the confirmed formula of solving ikhtilaf. Now, if you have any ikhtilaf with anybody in the world, you have any ikhtilaf with your neighbor, you have any ikhtilaf with your relative, with your brother, husband and wife, father and children, friends of old have become enemies, competitors in business, people in the area, one country to another country, one family to another family, any kind of ikhtilaf, we have the formula to solve it. So the first question is, has it been applied? Has it been applied? And that is what's mentioned in this verse of the Quran. Allah Rabbul Alameen is mentioning that waskuru ni'matallahi alaykum, remember the favor of Allah on you, idh kuntum adan, that you were enemies and then you became friends. What is this referring to? This is referring to the ikhtilaf among the mushriks of Makkah, the Quraysh, the Arabs of old. When they used to fight among themselves, they were exemplary ikhtilaf. They were having exemplary ikhtilaf. You killed one person from our tribe, we are going to kill your full tribe. We are going to kill 10 people in return. For small issues, they used to fight for years. So remember this ikhtilaf, this was the height of ikhtilaf. And then Allah says that after that ikhtilaf, you became brothers. Huh? After that ikhtilaf, you became brothers. And they did become brothers. People who are ready to take their lives of each other, they were ready to give the life of each other for the sake of Allah, for the sake of Allah. So we find, what was it? What was it that was there at that time? That same thing is with us today. What they had, we also have, alhamdulillah. So this is the first verse which we see, and we are going to look at 5 evidences, inshallah, very quickly. Second thing, the hadith from Sahih Bukhari. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تختلفوا, don't fall into ikhtilaf. فَإِنَّ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ اِخْتَلَفُوا فَهَلَكُوا. For those before you, they fell into ikhtilaf, they fell into differences, and they were destroyed. Did mercy come on them? As people say, people quote a hadith which has been attributed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is supposed to have said, اِخْتِلَافُ أُمَّتِي رَحْمَةً, the ikhtilaf of my ummah is mercy. Even though the scholars of hadith, they tell us that this hadith, there are different categories of hadith, sahih, authentic, hasan, little lesser but still counted as reliable, good, then there's weak, and then there's fabricated. They say la asla lahu. For this hadith, we don't get a sanad only. Meaning it's neither of these categories, you just don't get a sanad, meaning the chain of narration is only not found. Where has it come from? Which book of hadith, which narrator has narrated it? It's not found only. La asla lahu. There's no origin to it only. So it has just been attributed in the name of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even though it's nowhere. So what did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam actually say? He said, don't fall into ikhtilaf. For those before you, they fell into ikhtilaf and they were destroyed. Halaku. So this is the second evidence we see today. And my dear brothers, I'll give you an example. If you go on top of a very tall tower and you're looking down the terrace or the edge, so you will take care that you don't fall, because you know that this is very bad. If I fall, no chance of being saved. So we don't have to give a khutbah that we go, when you go on top of the tower, be careful, because people know it's bad. People themselves take care. If people realize how bad ikhtilaf is, they will themselves do something to solve it. They will themselves do something to avoid it. We don't have to give khutbah on the subject. But since people don't realize, so we are looking at the ayat of the Quran and the hadith, what has been mentioned. In the first ayat we saw that you are on the edge of the fire of hell. وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَىٰ هُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ. And the second we are looking at, that فَحَلَكُوا, they were destroyed. Third, Allah Rabbul Alameen mentions in Surah Al-Imran, Surah number 3, verse number 105, Allah Rabbul Alameen says that, in this verse Allah says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ تَفَرَّقُوا وَاخْتَلَفُوا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ. You don't be like those, you. You don't be, وَلَا تَكُونُوا, you, who you? تَكُونُوا, you Muslims. You don't be like those people. You Muslims, you followers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you don't become like those people. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ تَفَرَّقُوا, like those people, those followers of the prophets before Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You, the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you don't become like those. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ تَفَرَّقُوا, they got divided among themselves. وَاخْتَلَفُوا, and they fell into ikhtilaf. مِن بَعْدِ مَا جَاهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ, even though, even though clear evidences, clear proofs came upon them, even though they would see clear proof, yet they would fall into ikhtilaf, yet they would differ. So, you know, this is talking of an ikhtilaf where even if evidence comes, for example, we find in religious issues, there are so many ikhtilaf among Muslims, so many ikhtilaf. How to solve this ikhtilaf? We have to realize the way which has been mentioned, which we will see inshallah shortly, my dear brothers, but we have to realize that this, about this Allah has said, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ تَفَرَّقُوا وَاخْتَلَفُوا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاهَمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ. For them is a great punishment. For such people who differ and do fall into ikhtilaf, there is great punishment. So there's no rahmah for them, there's no mercy for them, there's punishment for them who fall into ikhtilaf even after matters are clear, even after things become clear. So this is the third thing we see today. Fourth, we look at it, Surah Anfal, Surah number 8, verse number 46. As Allah says, وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا, don't fall into ikhtilaf, don't fall into differences. فَتَفْشَلُوا, otherwise you will become weak. وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ, and your strength will depart. Huh? تَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ, literally it means your air will go away, meaning your, you know, there's a kind of a air about somebody. In Urdu we say dabdaba, you know, there's a kind of people consider, oh, these people are something, that will go away. What impression you have on others, they will start looking at you as they are weak. For you will become weak and you will be considered weak. For tafshalu, you will become weak. وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ, you will be considered weak. Meaning at times somebody is weak and they think they are so strong. But you will be weak and you will be considered weak also. Both the things are being mentioned in this verse of the Quran. This is the fourth point we see today. And lastly, fifth point we see before we go to the solution area is a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ recorded in Sahih Bukhari. Our beloved Prophet ﷺ, he said, خَرَجْتُ لِأُخْبِرَكُمْ بِلَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرُ, I came out to tell you about Laylatul Qadr. Do you know Laylatul Qadr? What do we have to do? We have to search for it in the odd nights of the last 10 days of Ramadan. And there's a hadith that it's in the last 10 days of Ramadan. There's a hadith in the last week of Ramadan. And the Prophet ﷺ said that search for it in the odd nights of the last 10 days of Ramadan. The Prophet ﷺ had come out of his house to tell us how to get Laylatul Qadr. What is the way to get Laylatul Qadr? He had come out. خَرَجْتُ لِيُخْبِرَكُمْ بِلَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ فَتَلَاحَ فُلَانٌ وَفُلَانٌ. And I saw that so and so, this one and this one, they were fighting. I saw that these two people were fighting. Fulanun wa fulanun. فَرُوْفِيَاتْ, the knowledge of Laylatul Qadr was taken away. The knowledge of Laylatul Qadr was taken away. Why? It's a lesson to be learnt. It's a lesson that we remember. We should remember this lesson. It was taken away due to ikhtilaf. Due to ikhtilaf. It's obvious. Now, my dear brothers, what do we learn from this part, this point? We learn that when Muslims fall into ikhtilaf for the sake of ikhtilaf, so that's where knowledge goes away. That's where knowledge is taken away. Knowledge, we are deprived of knowledge due to ikhtilaf, which is for the sake of ikhtilaf. Now, I believe that these points are basically sufficient to realize that ikhtilaf is something bad. My dear brothers and sisters, we will inshallah see 5 points which are points of solution which every single one of us can inshallah apply in our personal life. But before we look at these 5 points, there's one master key. There's a master key to solve ikhtilaf. And this is talking of religious ikhtilaf. See, there are two types of ikhtilaf. There's ikhtilaf which is due to religion. Okay, I think this masala is correct. I think this is correct. Two people are having two views. What should we do? So people have come up with many formulas. Today, alhamdulillah, many people have realized that ikhtilaf is bad. Many people. But there is ikhtilaf, how to solve ikhtilaf. There are differences about how to solve differences. So some people say that, see, you're saying 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. And he's saying 2 plus 2 is equal to 5. And he's saying 2 plus 2 is equal to 6. Forget your differences. We all are one. 2 plus 2, 4, 2 plus 2, 5, 2 plus 2, 6, let's forget it. We all are one. Now what is this? This is cosmetic therapy. You just put a carpet and the problem is below the carpet. Huh? There's a makeup and below that the skin is bad. So now what? We have to look at real solutions, not make-believe solutions. We need real answers. How to solve ikhtilaf? This is very important. How to solve ikhtilaf? So some people say that Some people say, what the majority are doing, let's do that. But after staying in countries like I come from India, which have democracy, people think that when votes are counted, whichever party gets the maximum votes is the ruling party. So people develop the psychology that even in religious issues, whatever masala gets the maximum votes, this is the correct masala. But Allah says in Surah 5 verse 100 that good and bad are not alike. وَلَوْ عَجَبَكَ كَثْرَةُ الْخَبِيثِ Even though the bad thing, which is so much, it puts you in astonishment, oh, so much bad, yet it is not equal to good. Bad is bad, good is good. So this is not real solution. Some people say 2 plus 2, 4 is also correct. 2 plus 2, 5 is also correct. 2 plus 2, 6 is also correct. We are one. What solution is this? This is not going to last. It has not worked, it will not work. So my brothers, there's a problem. What's the problem? Do you know? If there was one such verse of the Quran which we could find, one such hadith of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which was to tell us, if you fall into ikhtilaf, do this, your problem will be solved. What we need? See, don't do ikhtilaf is mentioned. Don't do ikhtilaf, don't do ikhtilaf, don't do ikhtilaf. Fatafshalu, you will fall weak, you will become your air, your strength will depart. But if we were to find a verse of the Quran, if we were to find a hadith of the beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if we were to find this which was to tell us, if you fall into ikhtilaf, do this, and your problem will be solved. That is the solution we want. That is what we need. And do you know, my brothers, there is a verse of the Quran which says this very thing. It's in Surah Nisa, Surah 4, verse 59. It's easy to learn because this is a formula, master key this is. 4 plus 5 is equal to 9. Surah Nisa, Surah 4, verse 59. Allah says in the Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu, O you who believe, Atiullah, obey Allah. Wa atiur rasul, obey the messenger. Wa ulil amri minkum, and those charged in authority among you. Those in authority among you. Now do you know there are several places in the Quran where it's mentioned Atiullah wa atiur rasul, Atiullah wa rasul. But this is the only place in the Quran where this third category is mentioned. Atiullah wa atiur rasul wa ulil amri minkum. Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he says ulul amr, they are ulama and hukam. They are the ulama and the rulers, the khalifa. Huh? Obey Allah, obey the messenger and obey those in authority. So now, listen to the ulama. Now, when we talk of Allah and His Rasul, so who's your Rasul? He'll say Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Who's your Rasul? You'll say Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Who's your Rasul? Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. There's no ikhtilaf. No problem. All of us are the followers of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But when we come to Ulul Amr, so one person will say, I listen to so-and-so ulama. I will listen to so-and-so ulama. I will listen to so-and-so, such and such ulama. This is where the ikhtilaf is. And in this very same place, the verse continues and Allah Rabbul Alameen has said, فَإِن تَنَازَاتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ If you fall into ikhtilaf, this is our question. If we fall into ikhtilaf, then what to do? Don't do ikhtilaf is mentioned. But if we fall into ikhtilaf, فَإِن تَنَازَاتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِ Then refer to Allah and His Messenger. Refer to Allah, means the Quran. Refer to the Messenger, means the beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now this is the solution. Allah says, "In kuntum tu'minuna billahi wal yawmil akhir." If you believe in Allah and in the last day. If you don't believe, then do what you want. But when you believe in Allah and the last day, then all ikhtilaf should go to ruddhu ila Allahi wa rasul. Refer to Allah, refer to the messenger. And two are mentioned. Final meaning, the statements of Allah are proof in itself. The statements of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam are proof in themselves. But the statements of scholars will become proof if they are in accordance with the statements of Allah Ta'ala or the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah has said, if you fall in differences, refer to Allah and His Messenger. In kuntum tu'minuna billahi wal yawmil akhir, dhalika khayrun. In this there will be good for you. In this there will be good for you. Wa ahsanu ta'wila, and the best consequences. So now, Imam Ahmad, he has commented. He said, which ikhtilaf, Shaykh Ibn Taymiyyah has also mentioned this, he said, which ikhtilaf we should refer to the Quran and the Sunnah, the big ones or the small ones? Should we refer the big ikhtilaf there or should we refer even small things there? So nay, Allah said, وَإِن تَنَازَاتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ If you fall in any differences, so any matters of differences, what we Muslims should do? We should say, see, I have this proof. What proof do you have? You have such and such proof? Chalo, let's go and see what's there in the Quran and the Sunnah. Whatever is over there, we will do. Inshallah. This is the solution. But do you know, now the problem has become bad because the problem has gone into our hearts. So we have to look at five solutions, inshallah. And brothers, if you have ikhtilaf with anybody, if you apply these five formulas, which I'll quickly tell you, inshallah, from the Quran and the Sunnah, you can solve your those ikhtilaf, inshallah. Very first point. The first point to solve ikhtilaf is we should love each other. We should love each other. Is the love there in our heart or no? There's a hadith of Sahih Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Walladhi nafsi biyadihi, by him in whose hands is my soul, la tadkhuluna al-jannah, you will not go to Jannah, hatta tu'minu, until you don't have iman, wa la tu'minu hatta tahabu, and you don't have iman until you don't love each other, until you don't love each other." So we should have this love for each other. Wa la tu'minu hatta tahabu. So my brothers, do we have love for everyone? For all Muslims, they are brothers, they are brothers. Innamal mu'minuna ikhwa, believers are brothers. Do we have that love in our heart for each other? Put it, because you have no iman if you don't have that love. If you don't have love, you don't have iman. Huh? We want iman, we need to have that love. Point number one. And whatever is needed to get the love, we should do. Whatever. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, afshu salama bainakum. Spread salam among you. Assalamu alaikum. Be the first one to say. So when you say salam to each other, may peace be on you, may protection, salamati be on you. So alhamdulillah, you feel good, and this is a sincere dua. So we friend says, afshu salama bainakum. He said, tahabu, tahadaw, tahabu. Give hadiya, gifts to each other, you will love each other. So give gifts. When people think of gifts, you can only see gifts coming. Huh? Nobody gives me gifts. You should also be giving gifts. Huh? So first point is loving each other for Allah's sake. For the sake of, not for the sake of money, not for the sake of anything else, for the sake of Allah. Love for the sake of Allah. Number two, after love, second thing is, when you speak good things. When we speak, we should speak good things. So we find that shaitan takes a chance to sow discord. It's mentioned in Surah Al-Isra, Surah 17, verse 53. Allah says that, say to my slaves, that they should say, Hiya ahsan, that which is best. We should say things which are best. Inna shaitana yanzaghu bainahum. Shaitan sows discord, ikhtilaf among them. Shaitan makes them divided because of this tongue. And do you know this tongue is responsible for so many things? And so many people, they say, when I speak, I can tear a person apart. It's not good. This tongue is responsible for so much ikhtilaf. So my brothers, let's stop talking, thinking of others. Think about yourself. Think about yourself. Let us all think about ourselves. And let us think, how am I with my tongue? How should we be with our tongue? We should speak what is good. And if we can't think something good, then keep quiet. Because shaitan gets the chance because of the tongue. And this was the best of the persons, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he used to speak that which is good, or otherwise he would say, kana kathir samti wa qalil ad-dahik. He would stay quiet for long periods of time and would laugh very little. This was our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Law addahul adul asahu. Sunan Abu Dawud hadith. If someone wanted to count how many things he said, could count. Huh? He said five things. So we find the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to speak less. So my brothers, do you know, so many ikhtilaf happen between people, brother and brother, husband, wife, friends and friends, neighbors, is because of what we say. So second thing is we should speak what is good. First thing is love in our heart. Second point, speak what is good. These are five things out of many things. But let us memorize five and leave today, inshallah. And if you are with me, you'll remember all five, inshallah. First is love in your heart. Second is speak good with your tongue. Third, good assumptions. Good assumptions. Do you know, my dear brothers, Allah said in the Quran that avoid assumptions. Inna ba'da zan ism. Some assumptions, some guman, some assumptions. What you assume, ha, he's thinking this about me. Some assumptions are sins. These are sins. And Sahih Bukhari hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said, iyyakum wa zan, avoid assumptions. Inna zanna akzabul hadith. Because zan, assumptions, are the worst of the false things. Akdabul hadith, worst of the false things that are said, assumptions. Do you know what happens? You're walking on the street, you say to someone, Assalamu alaikum. Now he's lost in thoughts. And by the time he crosses you, then he realizes, ah, he said something. But you didn't hear, Walaikum assalam. So you say, he surely has something bad in his heart for me. Huh? Now what? This is assumption. Iyakum wa dhan. Avoid assumption. Iyakum, avoid those assumptions. Huh? We have to avoid. So now you're calling up someone, he's not taking the call. Maybe his phone is silent. Maybe he didn't hear the ring. Maybe his office has some other problem. He's kept the phone somewhere. But he's not taking my call. Surely there's something wrong. Huh? This is very common. So we should think good assumptions. Huh? You can see someone laughing. He's surely laughing on me. But maybe he's something else. There's something else. Have good assumptions. Now there are hundreds of things going on in the mind. All in the mind. And we have, you know, reality we can face. Assumptions we can't fight. Assumptions we have to avoid. So first point was love in the heart. Second point is speak good things. Now someone said something to you, have good assumptions. Have good assumptions. 3 points. Fourth point. You're doing 3 things. You have love in the heart. You're speaking good things. You're having good assumptions. Still someone says something or does something bad to you. Someone has done something bad to you. Now what? Now what? Allah says in the Quran in Surah Nur, Surah 24, that Falyafu, let them forgive, Walyasfahu, and overlook. Ala tuhibbuna yaghfir Allahu lakum. Don't you like that Allah should forgive you? You want Allah to forgive you? Is there someone over here who says, no, even if Allah doesn't forgive, I'm fine? Is there someone over here who says, even if Allah doesn't forgive me in anything, I'll still go to Jannah? You think so? وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَسْفَهُوا. Let them forgive and overlook. Overlook meaning don't count also. Allah تُحِبُّونَ. Don't you love that Allah should forgive you? You want Allah to forgive you, but you don't want to forgive anybody. If we do this, I want Allah to forgive me, but I won't forgive anyone. Then what will be? What will it be? This is contradictory. Do you know in Ramadan when we read the dua in Laylatul Qadr? Allahumma innaka afuwan tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. Oh Allah, you are the forgiving one and you love forgiveness, so forgive me. Allah loves people to forgive also. Allah loves wa tuhibbul afwa. Allah loves that people forgive. So you know, my dear brothers, Allah says, do you want me to forgive you? And you don't want to forgive anyone. So I'll just mention one hadith mentioned in Sahih Bukhari. This is in Sahih Muslim. Authentic hadith. Of course, Sahih Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Tuftahu abwabul jannah yawm al-ithnan wa yawm al-khamis." The gates of Jannah are opened every Monday and every Thursday. Today is Friday, it will now open on Monday. Huh? Just remember this. The gates of Jannah are opened every Monday and every Thursday. Fayughfaru likulli abdin la yushriku billahi shay. Every single slave of Allah who doesn't associate anyone with Allah, he's forgiven on these days, Monday and Thursday. Monday, Thursday, Monday, Thursday. People who don't join others with Allah, they are forgiven. With sins, minor sins. But at least minor sins go on Monday and Thursday. Illa, except, rajulan, kanat bainahu wa bainakhi shahna. Except those two people, between whom and their brother, the one and his brother, there is something bad in their hearts. These two people, who are not associating anyone with Allah, but they have bad in their heart. Hearts are full of something bad. Shahna. Fayuqal, it is said, andhiru hadaini hatta yastaliha. Leave their matter pending until they don't do solve their issue. This is said 3 times. Wow, you heard this hadith? So if you have anything bad in your heart for someone, your matter is pending. Since I don't know when. My dear brothers, every hadith, every ayat of the Quran is for amal, for action, for belief. I encourage you, if you're sitting here in this khutbah with bad feelings in your heart for anyone, forgive him. Forgive him. Leave that baggage. Go ahead without that baggage. Huh? You'll feel so light in your heart. You'll feel so good inside, inshallah. Huh? Come on, today, now, don't leave it for Monday also. So that when Monday will come, when everybody of Tawheed is forgiven, inshallah, even we are forgiven. Huh? So if you have something bad in your heart for anyone, now, forgive him. For whose sake? For Allah's sake. You know, I've seen one thing, and you can also see that when people go in a shop and they really harass the shopkeeper at times, really bad comments, you are like, and you can see people who work in offices, a boss is in a bad mood, he's fought with his wife and come. So he told, get out. He said, yes, sir. Nicely, he forgives his boss. You know, boss, with the boss, people are very forgiving. They don't give fitting reply. Boss, you said this, I'm going to tell you this. You get out. Huh? No, they're forgiving with the boss. But when it comes to others, somebody in the masjid, one of your relatives, then you're made of glass. There you're made of steel. So with the boss, made of steel. Before the customer, made of steel. But you're made of glass, ready to break. So my brothers, we are talking today in this masjid about forgiving for, not for money, for Allah. Huh? Forgiving for the sake of Allah. Let's forgive. Right now, inshallah. See, listen to the advice and act on it, inshallah. From the Quran and the Sunnah. Fourth point. First point was love in the heart. Second point is speak good. Otherwise, keep quiet. If you can't speak good, keep quiet. Third point is good assumptions. Akdabul hadith. The worst of the false things are assumptions. So many problems are. If you look at husband-wife problems, when you do counseling for husband and wife, what's the problem? 90% of the problems are assumption. Huh? 90% of the problems are assumption. Leave the assumption. Fourth point is, if you still think something is wrong, forgive. And the last fifth point for today, if we are doing these four things, inshallah, there's one fifth thing also we need to consider. Do you know, my brothers and sisters, when two people fight, the third one there, normally, he sits with a can of oil. Says, see, you are so good with him, and see what he's telling you. See how you did with him, and what he's doing with you. So he sits with a can of oil. Some people, their food is not digested until they don't make people fight. So they need somebody to fight to make their food get their food digested. So we find in the hadith and in the ayat of the Quran that when two people fight, do you know what we should do? We should do sulah. We should do sulah. And Allah says, "Innamal mu'minuna ikhwa," believers are brothers. "Faslihu bayna khawaykum," do sulah among your two brothers. And do you know the Prophet said? He said, "Afdalu sadqa," the best sadqa, al-islahu zat al-bayni, is to do sulah among two people. And he said, should I tell you something? Hadith recorded in Sahih al-Jami'. Should I tell you something which is better than sa'im and qa'im? There's a person who's fasting Monday, Thursday, 13, 14, 15, fasting person, always. And qa'im, he's awake in the night and praying tahajjud. Last one third of the night, he's praying tahajjud. Prophet said, should I tell you something which is better than this also? He said, al-islahu zat al-bayni, doing sulah among two people. So my brothers, you know, the best sadaqah, not even 1 rupee goes, but you can get the reward of the best sadaqah, and you can reach the status of sa'im and qa'im, alhamdulillah, is by doing sulah. So now what we should do? Prophet also said this. He said, lays al-qadhib, he's not a liar, who, for the sake of sulah, yanmi khairan or yaqulu khairan, he tells some good thing. And he tells some good thing about from behind the back. So he says, see, I was sitting with that person. He didn't say anything bad about you. I don't think there's anything bad in his heart for you. He just said it. Now every person, these two people who are fighting, every person they meet, he's trying to get afdalus sadaqah, the best sadaqah. Everyone is trying to say something. So how long this ikhtilaf is going to last? We can solve the ikhtilaf. We have an intrinsic automatic system to solve ikhtilaf. So my dear brothers, these are 5 points from the Quran and Sunnah. Of course, there are many other things. 5 things we remember today. Finally, I'll read one hadith and we'll end this khutbah here. This hadith is in Sahih Muslim. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Inna shaitana qad aisa an ya'budahu al-musallun fi jaziratil Arab." Shaitan is disappointed. He has no hope that the people who offer salah in the Jaziratul Arab, in the Arabian Peninsula, they will worship him again. Shaitan is disappointed. He has no hope that these people who offer salah, they are going to worship me again. No chance. Walakin fit tahrishi bainahum. But in their internal disputes, Shaitan has lot of hope. Shaitan has lot of hope. I can make these people fight. So the Prophet ﷺ warned us. And let us all try to solve this problem on an individual family level. Because finally the society is made up of these families, individual persons. Let us solve everyone, until we can solve our ikhtilaf. And indeed there's strength in unity. May Allah Rabbul Alameen unite us on the Quran and the Sunnah. May Allah make us of those who serve Allah's deen and stay steadfast on His religion. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده رسوله اما بعد فان خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الامور محدثاتها وكل محدثه بدعه وكل بدعه ضلاله وكل ضلاله في النار وقال تعالى في كلامه المجيد واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا وقال تعالى في كلامه المجيد يا ايها الذين امنوا ادخلوا في السلم كافه ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان انه لكم عدو مبين وقال تعالى في مقام اخر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر ان الانسان لفي خسر الا الذين امنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر ربنا اتينا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار ربنا تقبل منا انك انت السميع العليم وتب علينا انك انت التواب الرحيم اللهم صل على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما صليت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما باركت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد اقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب واستغفروه انه هو الغفور الرحيم.